you join me at the, well, not far away from my camping spot. I got about half a mile to walk across some fields to my permission woodland. I thought I'd just do this one camp today. It's the last camp I'm going to do with some winter kit, because we're moving into warmer weather, springtime. So I brought with me the Polish teepee that I modded with the skirt to go round it, and I've got my titanium stove as well. So I got to hike these into the woods, and the big heavy rucksack. It's really heavy bit of kit, so I'm glad I'm able to bring the car part of the way. It makes it a lot easier. So let's get over into the woods, find a campsite, get set up. I've got myself a lovely curry to cook, chicken curry tonight. Woodland floor, very very fragrant this time of year. Lots of ground ivy around here. When you tread upon it, you crush the leaves and it releases that wonderful woodland smell. Whenever I come into the woods, it's so silent that the silence sort of permeates you, and you feel that you can only talk in a hushed voice. And I always feel that when I come into the wood, that this, I've mentioned it in previous videos, I'm only a visitor. There's animals that live here and creatures that live here. This is their permanent home. So I feel that I've got to bear that in mind in whatever I do when I come into a woodland. I always go round the tent before I start putting stuff in it, just to make sure that all the pegs are in where they want to be. Sometimes it just means moving a peg just a couple of inches to get that perfect pitch. That's not too bad though. This is the silky big boy 2000 professional 6.5, kind gift from a subscriber, Martin. Thanks Martin, beautiful saw. But there is a technique to get the best out of it, and you can saw single-handedly like that, but it's a pull saw, and so the best results I find, stand sideways on, both hands on the handle, then put your shoulders into it and it bites through that no problem, and you can put a bit of downward pressure on with this hand. You're using two arms and you're pulling with your shoulder muscles. It's not so tiring. This is a really hard piece of wood as well. Look at that, straight through. Beautiful. Time to get the fire lit. Very easy process this time of year because everything's quite dry. I've graded my fuel, so I've got kindling, small twigs, medium sized twigs, you can even use that as cooking fuel, and then I've got the main cooking fuel, And something like that, that's going to burn for an hour or more. So, but you need to get a real good hot fire going before you put something like that in. So let's get some wood in the fire. I always like to put a little bit of wood in first. Just to give the fire a base. It helps airflow as well. You need a good bit of airflow. And in here I've got fire lighting material. I got wax impregnated sort of cotton pad things, you know. Just get that lit. And then put some fuel on top, it'll soon go. That'll be roaring before you know it. Myself a lovely curry, and I've got all the ingredients in there for the vegetables for the curry. I'm going to make this a chicken curry, so there's my chicken, bits of chicken. But in this pot here, I'm going to put my rice, so that can go in there now. Obviously it's going to take a little while to cook because rice can take, 20 minutes, 30 minutes. So I'm going to get the rice on now. In the distance, you can see Liddington Hill Fort, or Liddington Hill. Beloved of our local authors and poets, Richard Jeffries and Alfred Williams. Alfred Williams came from a village not far away from here. On the left hand side of the hill you can see a clump of trees. There used to be, during the Second World War, an artificial air base or an artificial town to draw the enemy bombers away from the local town of Swindon. On the right hand side, somewhere over there, that's where Liddington Castle, the actual hill fort itself, is, and you may just be able to make it out. Can I zoom in any more? No, I can't. I think that's it. Just had the most wonderful sunset, and it was illuminating this oak tree. I don't know if you can see the oak tree there. So I'm not used to this camera, so I set it up to take a photograph, and I think I just managed to catch the light just as the sun was dipping down. You've got to be on location at the right time to get the right light, I think. I think I was just lucky there. Shut one of the doors down, it was all wide open. Now shut it down a little bit and it's kept it lovely and warm in here. The stove's banging out some lovely heat. There's my rice all fluffed up nice, ready to eat, and I think my curry. That's well cooked, that is. I'm going to take it off and let it cool down a little bit, and then I think what I might do is I like adding my rice to my curry, so mix it all into one. I'm not going to be able to eat all that. Look at it, look at it. Look, bits of chicken like that. Oh, it's just, wow, smells delicious. It's still just too hot at the moment, so I'm just going to let it cool. But I'm sure I'm going to really enjoy it. It's hot. Curry's beautiful. It's really tasty. I added a spoonful of honey into it as well to give it a bit of sweetness. I'm hot. I'm down t-shirts, taking my old army boots off. Good pair of boots, I think. I haven't managed to wear these out. I normally get a pair of boots that last about a year, year and a half if I'm lucky. So these are my everyday wearers now. And they're beginning to take on the shape of my feet, or my feet are taking on the shape of the boot. They're becoming comfortable. It's hot. Crikey, it's so hot in here. It's forecast is supposed to get down to about minus one tonight, and I am absolutely stifling. I've got to open the door again. I'm just struggling with the curry as well. Well, there's the tent over there, the Polish teepee. And I've just taken a panoramic shot where I put the camera into portrait mode and done a time exposure, because there's a beautiful moon. Not that you can see it very well with the video camera rolling, but I'm hoping with the timed exposures in pano mode you might be able to see that. So I'll put that up next. One last thing I'm going to do before going to bed, listen to put the recorder on. It'll record for an hour and hopefully pick up some nighttime sounds in the forest or in the woods. That's it, recording now. Hopefully the non-stick coated on this pan will last if I look after it. Do for my breakfast, a bit of naan bread and bacon.
Lovely. Coffee's on the go as well. Back home now. Two dogs are waiting for me, I believe. I don't know how they're going to react.
Hello!
Oh, look!
Are you happy? Are you happy? Are you happy, are you? Carmen, you want a walkie? Carmen! How about you? Sita!